وقل جاء الحق وزهق الباطل وقل جاء الحق وزهق الباطل إن الباطل كان زهوقا.
Okay, but also the rulers are kafir because they make tahakum to the taghut of United Nations. They are kafir because they make tawalli, allying with the kuffar against Muslims, and they are fighting against Islam. They are kafir because they legislate, they make tashri', they make istihlal, they make the alcohol halal, they make the gambling halal, many of the countries. They make even prostitution halal. You know, they make some of them, even Saudi Arabia, they make their interest, the riba halal as well. So there are many reasons why they are kuffar. Not just one, but no one of them should be allowed to be corrupted or all the people misguided in those matters.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد. As you have heard the brother say now that the rulers are kafir for many different reasons and that Saudi Arabia they make interest halal. Saudi Arabia they make interest halal. And this is something that is known with this brother. When Ustad Abdul Rahman Hassan debated him in the Khilafah debate, he said that the lands of Mecca and Al-Medina are the lands of the Kuffar. Mecca and Medina are the lands of the Kuffar. طيب. Before inshallah ta'ala I move on to explaining this doubt, because there's many, many different things that he mentioned in the video, as you heard, but I just want to concentrate on this one matter, which is the issue of istihlal. What is the ruling of istihlal? What is the meaning of istihlal? How do I know when a person has fallen into istihlal? This is what I'm going to go into in a minute, inshallah ta'ala. But before I do that, brothers and sisters, what I want to make clear here is the importance of clarifying the doubts of the people of innovation. Clarifying the situation of the people of innovation. You find some people, they will close this bab, this door altogether. And they call it what? This guy is insulting or this guy is doing ghiba. He is backbiting. But in reality, this is something that is part of the religion. And it's a form of jihad, striving. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he mentioned in the hadith that was narrated by Imam Muslim, of when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, مَا مِن نَبِيٍّ بَعَثَهُ اللَّهُ قَبْلِي إِلَّا وَكَانَ مَعْهُ مِنْ أُمَّتِهِ حَوَارِيُّونَ. There was never a prophet that was sent before me, except that he had from his ummah, from the people that were with him, حواريون, disciples. وَأَصْحَابٌ يَأْخُذُونَ بِسُنَّتِهِ. And he had companions who used to take from his sunnah. وَيَقْتَدُونَ بِهَدِيَ. And they used to take and imitate his guidance. ثُمَّ بَعْدَ ذَلِكَ خَلَفَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ خُلُوفٌ يَقُولُونَ مَا لَا يَفْعَلُونَ وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا لَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. Then after them came people. They used to say that which they never done. وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا لَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. And they used to do that which they weren't commanded with. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam says, فَمَنْ جَاهَدَهُمْ بِيَدِهِ فَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. Whoever strives against them with his hand, he's a believer. وَمَنْ جَاهَدَهُمْ بِلِسَانِهِ فَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. And whoever strives against them with his tongue, he's a believer. وَمَنْ جَاهَدَهُمْ بِقَلْبِهِ فَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ. And whoever strives against them with his heart, he's a believer. وَلَيْسَ وَرَاءَ ذَلِكَ حَبَّةُ خَرْدَلٍ مِنَ الْإِيمَانِ. And after that, there is no mustard grain of iman remaining. So what does that show you? Striving against the people of innovation is a form of jihad. Did I say this? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this, and this hadith narration is found in Sahih Muslim. Also, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لا يمنعن أحدكم هيبة الناس أن يقول في حق. Do not let the fear of the people prevent you to say the truth. إذا رآه, if a person sees it, أو سمعه أو شهده, or when a person hears it or witnesses it. The hadith was narrated by Imam Ahmad on the authority of Abi Sa'id al-Khudri رضي الله عنه. So when you hear batil or when you see batil, or when you witness batil, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling you, do not let the fear of the people stop you from saying the haqq. Speaking the haqq is a form of rif'ah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raising you. And this is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told Ubad ibn Samit. Ubad ibn Samit said, bay'na Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ala sam'i wa ta'a fi al-usri wal yusr. We gave our oath of allegiance to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the ease, times of ease and the times of hardship. وَكَذَلَكَ السَّمْعُ وَالطَّاعَةُ to listen and obey. وَفِي الْعُسْرِ وَالْيُسْرِ in times of ease and times of hardship. وَالْمَنْشَطِ وَالْمَكْرَحِ وَعَلَى أَثْرَةٍ عَلَيْنَا and also when there is greed against us. When we are oppressed. وَأَنْ لَا نُنَازِعَ الْأَمْرَ أَهْلَهِ إِلَّا أَنْ تَرَوْا كُفْرًا بَوَاحًا عِنْدَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ فِيهِ بُرْهَانٍ and not to go against the ruler until you see clear-cut kufr. And the point that I'm trying to get across here is this statement, وَأَنْ نَقُولَ فِي الْحَقِّ أَيْنَمَا كُنَّا وَلَا نَخَافُ فِي اللَّهِ لَوْمَةَ لَائِمٍ that we say the haqq wherever we are and we don't fear the blame of the blamers. Speaking the truth, when you see it, hear it, and not fearing the blame of the blamers is what the Sahaba, they gave bay'ah to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam upon. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He cursed. As Allah Azza wa Jal mentions, لُعِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ Bani Israel, they were cursed from those that disbelieved. عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاؤُودِ وَعِيسَ بْنَ مَرْيَمِ upon the tongue of Daud and Isa ibn Maryam. ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ that was because they used to violate and they were disobedient. Why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala curse them? كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهَوْنَ عَن مُنْكَرٍ فَعَلُوهُ they never used to disapprove of the munkar that they or the people used to do in front of them. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ فَأَنْجَيْنَا الَّذِينَ يَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ السُّوءِ You now disapproving of the evil that's taking place around you is a form of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saving you from the destruction that might take place. As Allah Azza wa Jalla said, فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ And when they forgot what they were reminded with, أَنْجَيْنَا الَّذِينَ يَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ السُّوءِ We save those who used to prohibit the evil that used to take place. So the issue of Amr bil Ma'ruf wa Nahi anil Munkar is something that is known and concrete in our religion. Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, volume 28, page 231. قِيلَ لِي أَحْمَدْ ibn Hanbal. It was said to Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahimahullah ta'ala, أَنَّهُ يَثْقَلُ عَلَيَّ أن أقول فلان كذا وفلان كذا. It was said to him that it is hard for me to say that this guy is like this and this guy is like this. This Imam Ahmed is being said to. فقال إذا سكت أنت وسكت أنا. So he said to him, if I keep quiet now and you keep quiet as well. فمتى يعرف الجاهل الصحيح من السقيم. How are the people meant to differentiate between the jahil sahih and the guy that is sick, the ignorant guy that is sick, misguided individual? وَمِثْلُ أَئِمَّةِ الْبِدَعِ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْمَقَالَاتِ الْمُخَالَفَةِ لِلْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْمَقَالَاتِ الْمُخَالِفَةِ لِلْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ And also, how are the people meant to know and differentiate between the scholars of bid'ah? From those who have speeches that go against the kitab and the sunnah or al-ibadat al-mukhalifa lil-kitab wa sunnah or those who call to worships that go against the Quran and the sunnah. فَإِنَّ بَيَانَ حَالِهِمْ وَتَحْذِيرَ الْأُمَّةِ مِنْهُمْ وَاجِبٌ بِاتِفَاقِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ For indeed, clarifying their situation and warning against them, it is wajib, it is compulsory, unanimously agreed on by the Muslims. حتى قيل لأحمد بن حنبل. It was also said to Ahmad ibn Hanbal. الرجل يصوم ويصلي ويعتكف. A man, he fasts and he prays and he performs اعتكاف. أحب إليك أو يتكلم في أهل البدعة. في أهل البدعة. Is the one that fasts, prays, huh? And does اعتكاف. We're talking about the nawafil here. Is this person more beloved to you than the one that speaks against the people of innovation and clarifies the situation? فقال إذا قام وصلى واعتكف فإنما هو لنفسه. If this person now prays, huh? And he fasts and he does also i'tikaf, فإنما هو لنفسه. This is only for himself. He's only benefiting himself. وإذا تكلم في أهل البدع فإنما هو للمسلمين. But when this person now speaks about the people of innovation, makes their situation clear, this is for the Muslims. يعني this is something that is universal, a lot of people benefit from. هذا أفضل and this is more virtuous. فبين أن نفع هذا عام للمسلمين. And he clarified and made it clear that this brings bigger benefit to more the general Muslims. في دينهم من جنس الجهاد. That when he does this, like it brings more benefit to them in their religion, and this is now from the forms of jihad. So inshallah ta'ala, what we need to understand, what is the meaning of istihlal? When this brother now mentioned that Saudi Arabia make riba halal, na'am, he has made takfir of Saudi Arabia from this angle, even though he mentioned other things, but inshallah ta'ala, in upcoming episodes, we're going to clarify every single one. But at this very moment, we need to know the meaning of istihlal. طيب. Ibn Taymiyyah رحمه الله تعالى, he mentions in Majmu' al-Fatawa, volume number 3, page 267, وَالْإِنسَانُ مَتَى حَلَّلَ الْحَرَامَ الْمُجْمَعَ عَلَيْهِ. When a person now makes halal, something that is haram, that has been unanimously agreed upon. أو حَرَّمَ الْحَلَالَ الْمُجْمَعَ عَلَيْهِ. Or he makes haram something that is halal and has been unanimously agreed upon. Or بدل شرع المجمع عليه. Or he replaces a legislation that has been unanimously agreed upon. كان كافرا مرتدا باتفاق الفقهاء. This guy is a kafir, he's a murtad, apostate, and this has been unanimously agreed by the fuqaha. So let me give you an example. بالمثال يتضح المقال. We know that pork is haram, and it is known in the religion of Islam with what? With durura. Are you with me? Does anyone have any doubt that pork is haram? Everybody knows this. الصحيح وكذلك الصقيم. طيب. If I come tomorrow and I say that pork is halal, what have I done? I've made something that is haram halal. And this is istihlal, as Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned. Are you with me, yeah? To make something that is haram halal, or to make something that is halal haram. I know salat is halal, صح? Something that is permissible. If I say to the people, no, salat is haram, what have I done? I've done istihlal. We know that killing is haram. If I say tomorrow, halal, istihlal, make something that is haram halal. Likewise, zina, we know it's haram. If I come tomorrow and say it's halal, I've made istihlal. And this is kufrun. And also he mentions, نعم, أن من فعل المحارم مستحلا لها فهو كافر باتفاق, بالاتفاق. And if someone now does something that is haram, but he what? Makes it halal. فهو كافر. This person is a kafir باتفاق. Unanimously agreed upon. So is that clear? Is the meaning of istihlal clear? طيب. Two things that I want the people to understand today. And they are the two main things that I want to speak about. Is what is the meaning of istihlal? So if you understood it, good. The second thing is, how do I know when someone now is performing istihlal or falling into istihlal? And the third thing is also, Ikhwani, that we need to pay attention to. What is the issue of istihlal? Is it from the matters of the heart? Is it not from the matters of the heart? Are you with me, yeah? Is it from the matters of the heart? Is it not from the matters of the heart? Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions, أَنَّ الْعَبْدَ إِذَا فَعَلَ الذَّنْبِ. If a servant now does a sin, مَعَ اعْتِقَادِ أَنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَهُ. At the same time, he believes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this haram. أن العبد إذا فعل الذنب, that when a servant he does something now, a sin, and at the same time he believes أن الله حرمه, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has made this haram. وَاعْتِقَادِ إِنْقِيَادِهِ لِلَّهِ فِيمَا حَرَّمَهُ وَأَوْجَبَهُ فَهَذَا لَيْسَ بِكَافِرٍ. And at the same time he submits and believes that which is made haram and also that which is made wajib. فَهَذَا لَيْسَ بِكَافِرٍ. So when a person now is doing something that is haram, at the same time he knows that which he's doing is haram, na'am, and at the same time he submits to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the matters that have been made compulsory, in the matters that have been made haram, this person is not kafir. So now brings us to an example now. If someone is drinking alcohol for 45 years, or is performing zina for 60 years, pay attention here. If someone is drinking alcohol for 50 years, or 45 years, however long it might be, or is doing zina for 60 years, he believes what he's doing is haram. Can we call this guy kafir? We can't call this guy kafir. Because he knows that this is haram. At the same time, he's doing a major sin, huh? Which is kabiratun min kaba'ir al-dhunub. It's a major sin. So that which should be underlined is the word i'tiqad. He Ibn Taymiyyah says, أن العبد إذا فعل ذنب ما اعتقادي. I'tiqad should be underlined. That shows you what? That this is now from the matters of the heart. It is from the matters of the heart. We can't say to a guy, you're only drinking alcohol because you believe it to be halal. Because you have been drinking it for so long, you believe it to be halal. We can't do that. Why? Because from the matters of the heart. Are you with me, eh? طيب. Because another thing we need to understand, the Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, they do not judge people except with that which is apparent. And I mentioned this last week as well. And we don't go looking at indications, this guy has done it for so long, akhi, this action indicates kada wa kada wa kada. Rather we take from the apparent. Rather we take from the apparent. Where is this taken from? The qissa of Usama ibn Zaydin radiyallahu anhu. What'd you call it? The man that Usama ibn Zayd got hold of, he was what? He was slicing the Muslims. He was chopping their heads off. Are you there with me? Usama ibn Zayd got hold of him and the man said, La ilaha illallah. What does it show? What are the indications? If we look at it now from a very long angle, what does it show now? He did it out of fear. And this is the exact same thing that Usama ibn Zayd radiallahu anhu mentioned. He only said, La ilaha illallah, out of fear. What did the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم say to him? أشققت قلبه أقتلته بعد أن لا إله أن قال لا إله إلا الله. Did you kill him now after he said لا إله إلا الله? Did you cut his heart open to see as to what his intentions were? Are you with me? Even though the indications were negative, his actions shows otherwise. But the fact that he said لا إله إلا الله, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم عاتبه على مش على قتله لهذا الرجل. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم addressed him and spoke to him in the manner that he spoke to him about, simply because he killed him after he said لا إله إلا الله. So the point that I'm trying to get across here and derive from this is that what? The قرائن, the indications, we do not judge people with the indications. And at the same time, we have to pay attention here. That Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah between two people. You have the Murji'ah who say, as long as a person says La ilaha illallah, no matter what he does, it doesn't affect it. So I could be saying La ilaha illallah, I'm prostrating to a sanam or prostrating to a grave, and at the same time be a Muslim. Are you with me? I could be prostrating to a grave at the same time I could say the guy is Muslim because he says La ilaha illallah. And this is what the Murji'ah say. The a'mal has been taken out altogether. And you have on the other side some of these brothers, those who have been afflicted and they've been trialed with a takfir. Wallahi, the guy, he's only doing this because he believes it to be halal. The guy's been drinking alcohol for 45 years because he believes it to be halal. Otherwise, he wouldn't do it. Why would he do it? When the guy is telling you, huh? When the guy is, akhi, wallahi, make dua for me. I know what I'm doing is wrong. Ahlul Sunnah, if they see a guy that says, La ilaha illallah. Let's just say in a battlefield. نحن نكف عنه ابتداء. We refrain from him. Then after that, if there's kufriyat minhu, we find kufriyat. This guy is now doing acts of kufr. خلاص, his hukum changes. Are you with me? How we judge them from the apparent. Then after that, if they start doing actions that go against the La ilaha illallah, the guy's hukum changes. We judge it from the apparent, which goes against the takfiris. Huh? And at the same time, the hukum changes. After kufriyat become apparent, that goes against the murjiah who are on the other side of this issue. So you have ta'ifatan, two groups who have understood, misunderstood the issue of Usama ibn Zayd in an incorrect manner. And you have Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah who have taken a balanced approach when it came to this matter. And you find a lot of people, a lot of groups taking this hadith, explaining it in their own way, and it causes a lot of ambiguity and a lot of things are unclear. Is that clear, ikhwan? Tayyib. Tayyib. How do we know now when someone has done istihlal? How do we know when someone has done istihlal? We just mentioned before that istihlal is from the matters of the heart. How can one now find out if a person now has fallen into istihlal? Sheikh Saleh Al-Fawzan and also Ibn Uthaymeen, they've got very, very similar speeches. Now I'm going to read out the kalam of Sheikh Saleh Al-Fawzan. وَسُئِلَ الشَّيْخُ الْفَوْزَانُ عَنْ ضَوَابِتِ الَّتِي يَنْبَغِي لِطَالِبِ الْعِلْمِ أَنْ يَعْرِفَهَا Sheikh Saleh Al-Fawzan, he was asked about the general principles that is upon a talib ilm, a student of knowledge, to know. لِكَيْ يَحْكُمُ عَلَى فُلَانِ مِنَ النَّاسِ بِأَنُّ مُسْتَحِلِ So that he's able to know when making a ruling against a guy from the people that he's someone that is doing istihlal. لِلْمَعْصِيَةِ He's doing something of istihlal in regards to a sin. المجمع على تحريمها Something that has been unanimously agreed upon. فأجاب وفقه الله وحفظه So he answered by saying الضوابط التي تدل على استحلال المعصية The general principle that shows that when one now is doing istihlal of a ma'asiyah of a sin أن يصرح الشخص بأنها حلال The one makes it clear with his tongue that it's halal. إِمَّا بِلِسَانِهِ Sorry. أَنْ يُصَرِّحَ الشَّخْصُ That one makes it clear. بِأَنَّ حَلَالَ That it's halal. إِمَّا بِلِسَانِهِ وَإِمَّا بِقَلَمِهِ Either with his tongue or with his pen. So until a person now says, zina is halal, we cannot know what this person believes until he says it with his tongue. Because we just mentioned the kalam of Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala. When he says, I'tiqad, and I told you to underline it, from the matters of the heart. One cannot find out what's in my heart until I actually save my tongue or I write down here on the board, na'am, that riba is halal. Are you with me? And that's the only way one can find out if someone is doing istihlal. And another dhabit that I'm going to mention inshallah ta'ala is what Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned when it comes to one doing istihlal based upon ijtihad. He says in the 7th volume, page 71, ثُمَّ ذَلِكَ الْمُحَرَّمُ لِحَلَالِ وَالْمُحَلِّلُ لِلْحَرَامِ So the guy now that's making something that is halal haram, or something that is halal, or haram halal, إِنْ كَانَ مُجْتَهِدًا قَصْدُهُ اِتِّبَاعُ الرَّسُولِ If this person now is striving to try and get the right answer, his intention now, his qasd, his purpose, ittiba'u rasul, it is to follow the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لكن خفي عليه الحق في نفس الأمر. But at the same time, the truth has become hidden from him. وَقَدِ اتَّقَ اللَّهَ مَا اسْتَطَاعَ And this person is fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of his ability. Like someone from the sunnah now, who fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, known to be from the people of Ittiba'. طيب. فَهَذَا لَا يُؤَاخِذُهُ اللَّهُ بِخَطَئِهِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala won't hold this person to account with his mistake. بَلْ يُثِيبُهُ عَلَى إِجْتِهَادِهِ Rather, he gives this person a reward for his ijtihad. الَّذِي أَطَاعَ بِهِ رَبَّهِ وَلَكِنْ مَنْ عَلِمَ أَنَّ هَذَا خَطَأ نعم. And بَلْ يُثِيبُ عَلَى إِجْتِهَادِ الَّذِي أَطَاعَ بِهِ رَبَّهِ And this person will become rewarded for the ijtihad in when he tried to worship his Lord. Are you with me? Sometimes istihlal can take place from an imam. He can make something that is haram halal. But he does it based upon ijtihad. He does it based upon ijtihad, striving to try and get the right answer. Someone striving to get the right answer, and he falls into istihlal, and you cannot make takfir of him straight away. Rather, there's shurut, there's mawani' that we need to take into consideration. Naam? So, a very, very quick recap. Five things that we need to take into consideration. The first thing is what? The meaning of istihlal, which we mentioned of the kalam of Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah ta'ala. The second thing, it is from the matters of the heart. The third thing, Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, they do not judge the people with indications. The fourth thing, how do we know when someone is falling into istihlal? إِمَّا أَن يُصَرِّحُ الشَّخْصُ إِمَّا أَن يُصَرِّحَ الشَّخْصُ بِلِسَانِهُ بِقَلَمِهِ. Someone makes the clay either with his tongue or with what? With his pen. He writes it down. And at the same time, brothers and sisters, I'm going to make it clear, Naam, that we do not defend those people who are falling into major sin. Wallahi, we don't. Rather, it's a kabira min kabair al-dhunub. Kabiratu min kabair al-dhunub. To deal with interest, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَا إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Oh, you who believe, leave of that which remains from riba, if you are believers. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا فَأْذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. And if you don't stop this, then you are proclaiming war with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Riba is a major sin. From the destructive sins, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اِجْتَنِبُوا سَبْعَ الْمُبِقَاتِ. Stay away from the seven destructive sins. From the things that he mentioned, أكل الربا. And there's many, many nusus, na'am, that talk about the حِرْمَان الْرِبَا. But at the same time, ikhwani, we need to differentiate. And I repeat this again due to its importance. We need to differentiate between me allowing my father to go take a loan, or me telling my son, go take that loan, or me allowing prostitution to come into my house. Does that necessitate that this is halal? It doesn't necessitate that. If I know that's wrong, and I say to you, akhi, wallahi, I know what I'm doing is wrong. Huh? I believe that what I'm doing is wrong, and I know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made wajib upon me. This is a major sin, and it is not istihlal. And this is what a lot of these brothers, they don't tend to differentiate between. Someone doing a particular action, and someone what? Making something halal, which is from the matters of the heart. And like we mentioned time and time again, ikhwani, we take the asbabun shar'iyya. We do not defend the rulers on their mistakes and their major sins. The asbabun shar'iyya is when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man arada an yansah li dhi sultanin, fala yubdihi lahu alaniya." Whoever now wants to advise a ruler, let this person not do this openly. فَلْيَأْخُذْ بِيَدِهِ فَيَخْلُوا بِهِ. Let him take him by the hand and seclude himself with him. That's what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us. And then he mentioned, إِنْ كَانَ قَدْ قَبِلَ مِنْكَ فَذَاكَ. If he accepts from you, then that's it. وَإِلَّا قَدْ أَدَّ الَّذِي عَلَيْهِ. The person he has established and fulfilled that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has fulfilled him to do, told him to do. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, وَلَا تُجَادِلْ عَنِ الَّذِينَ يَخْتَانُونَ أَنفُسَهُمْ. Do not dispute on behalf of those who oppress themselves. And also the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَمَنْ نَعَانَهُمْ عَلَىٰ ظُلْمِهِمْ وَصَدَّقَهُمْ بِكَذِبِهِمْ فَأُولَٰئِكَ لَيْسُ مِنِّي وَلَسْتُ مِنْهُمْ. And whoever aids them in their oppression and believes their oppression, then these people are not from me. فَمَنْ أَعَانَهُمْ عَلَىٰ ظُلْمِهِمْ وَصَدَّقَهُمْ بِكَذِبٍ فَأُولَٰئِكَ لَيْسُ مِنِّي وَلَسْتُ مِنْهُمْ. And whoever now aids them upon their oppression, and also what? Believes them in their oppression, this person is not from me and I'm not from him. So is that clear? We do not defend them on their mistakes. أَبَّدًا. We do not defend them on their mistake. Rather, we take the أسباب الشرعية, which is to advise them, and we don't have the ability, we write a letter to them. And that's what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us. So until we find Saudi Arabia coming out and saying Huh? That the riba is halal either clearly with their tongues or from a natiq rasmi, not from any Dom, Dick and Harry that is basically walking in the middle of the road. That's a Saudi laha. Natiq rasmi, official spokesman coming out and saying this halal, this is haram. Then until then, we're not able to judge them with falling into istihlal, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best.